Hojicha NFT presents.
Ever hear a song and wonder what it is? When that happens, most of us would turn to Shazam for the answer. While Shazam has millions of tracks in its database, YouTube Music's new sound search feature comes with a massive collection that includes not just songs, but also videos. With all this content, can YouTube step up to the plate against Shazam Senpai? Place your bet now, because we're about to put them in a head-to-head showdown. In this showdown, I'll be playing videos from various social platforms. To respect the copyrights of the soundtracks, the music will be blurred out in this video. If any song catches your vibe, feel free to check them out in the video description. Now, let the Hunger Games begin. In round one, we can see YouTube Music's recognition speed is supersonic. Even as we are watching, it has already recognized the song. On the other hand, Shazam was a bit slow, but still got the job done. Well, that's 1 point for YouTube. Moving on. Round 2 features a masterpiece by Joe Hisaishi. Given its classic status, YouTube Music identified it instantly. Shazam tried to close the gap, but luck wasn't in its lap. Round 2 to YouTube. Next. In the third round, we have a track from a French indie artist who's released only a few songs so far. I thought this would be a toughie for recognition, but both of them figured it out quickly. YouTube Music beat Shazam to the punch and has become the new Shazam. Next. The difficulty in round 4 cranks up with a Y2K vibe Jungle D&B track. Surprisingly, YouTube Music devoured it and left no crumbs. Whatever secret sauce the developers used behind the magic, it's got the recognition game down pat. Meanwhile, Shazam's over here acting like that one friend who takes forever to text you back. That, my friend, is another point for YouTube. You know, sometimes we hear music that just hits right in the craziest and busiest places. So next, we're upping the game from recognizing studio soundtracks to live performances. In round 5, we've got raw footage of Aurora performing live in a style different from the album version. The lo-fi audio makes it... Oh no, YouTube just fumbled for the first time. Guess rushing that dish wasn't always the move. Here we have Shazam cooking at its own pace, very mindful, very demure. But as we speak, YouTube has pulled ahead and correctly identified the song. Round 5 to YouTube. Into the final round. Finally, in the last round, we've got live footage of Adele's concert with fans screaming along. There's a chance that both of them might... Wait, what? YouTube Music just found a live concert recording that matches the song. That's crazy. It is a different concert from the footage I played. But man, this is still insane. As for Shazam, it hasn't been Shazamming much today. With that final knockout, YouTube Music took the crown with its lightning speed and accuracy. I imagine this level of precision will come in handy when you're trying to identify a song in noisy spots. So yeah, I think YouTube Music will be my go-to for identifying songs on the fly from now on. Also, did you notice how even lesser-known songs with unique sound designs were picked up so quickly? It hit me that it's not about fitting into the mainstream, but owning what makes you different, so the right people can find and connect with you through all the noise. Well, that's it for today. Don't be shy to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Take care, and I'll see you next time.